Anjali Rao. My guest today is Chun Do-yeon, the darling of South Korean cinema, and having scooped the Best Actress Award at Cannes this year, is also making a name for herself on the global movie stage. This is Talk Asia. A defining moment. Scooping the top actress at the Cannes Film Festival propels the winner into the limelight. And as the first recipient from Asia, Chun Do-yeon's surprise was genuine. She has since been named as one of the world's 50 most influential women by Variety magazine. Beginning her career as a model and actress in melodramatic soap operas, she's tackled such diverse roles as in a schoolgirl, romantic lead, and AIDS-infected bar girl. Her career benefiting from an upsurge of interest in Korean cinema. She won her award at Cannes this May for Secret Sunshine, in which she played a young widow who moves from Seoul to start a new life. The film is South Korea's official selection for consideration as Best Foreign Film at next year's Oscars.
Let's start with the Best Actress Prize, which you won at this year's Cannes Film Festival. What's it like being the first Korean ever to win such a prestigious award?
First of all, I wasn't really able to think about the significance of myself being the first Korean or the first Asian to win such a significant prize. However, now thinking about it, I do think it's more important that more female, more actresses, regardless of whether they're Western or Asian actresses, that they win prizes at this prestigious film festival. And thinking about it now, I do feel quite proud about it. And also feel like I have to put on a better performance now.
You won for your role in Secret Sunshine. Did you ever anticipate its success?
To tell you the truth, the director of the film, Lee Chang-dong, is not greatly loved by the public, and his films are not mainstream. But I did feel that while I was starring in the film, we did joke around, saying that this is probably going to be one of the most popular films among all of Lee Chang-dong's films. And I'm very glad that by winning this prize, it did receive a lot of interest from the public. And as an actress, I feel very proud and honored about it.
Still though, you weren't entirely convinced, were you, that your role in Secret Sunshine was right for you? What were your doubts about it?
I usually decide whether I'm going to star in a film or not based on how much I understand the scenario, not necessarily how much I understand the character of the film. In this case, it also depends on whether I'm emotionally drawn towards the story itself. In the case of Secret Sunshine, because it was something that I had never experienced before, I doubted myself and the story, whether a person can actually experience those kinds of emotions. So it was difficult for me to decide, despite the fact that I had been interested for a very long time to work with director Lee Chang-dong. The difficult thing for me was because I didn't trust entirely in the story itself. I doubted whether, as an actress, I could actually convey the story to the public or not.
You've also just been named as one of the 50 most influential women by Variety magazine, which is quite a feat in itself. And on that list, there are only four actresses, among them Angelina Jolie and also Helen Mirren. What's it like for you to see your name alongside these huge stars?
After I heard about that, I received a lot of phone calls from people congratulating me. And I got to think about what kind of impact I may have possibly had. But I actually thought, to put it quite simply, I just thought, wow, Angelina Jolie. And I wondered if she had seen my photo, if she had heard about me. And so that was pretty much it. I just felt good about it.
So melodramas in which you starred, such as The Contact and also A Promise, got you dubbed the Queen of Tears. What did you make of that label?
I guess it was good. I felt good about it, because whether it's a melodrama or not, it means that it was well received by the public. And in whatever form, Whether I be called the Queen of Tears or whatever it was, it felt good to be in the center of things. People usually like to title or label people, such as the Queen of Tears or Korea's Best Actress or whatever it may be. But I think what's more important than any title is the fact that I'm in the center of things. Not to say that being in the middle of everything is always good, but I believe as an actress, it's very important to go with the flow.
What do you think about the state of the South Korean film industry at the moment? Because a lot of people say, you know, it's in a crisis, it's all going downhill like in the 1990s. Do you think it is? Because a lot of people say that, you know, well, it's not that bad yet. You yourself have had quite a hand in rescuing things.
I would be quite honored if I could help the industry in any way, however small the effort. A lot of people do say it's a rough time for the industry. But I think it's the same as when a child is growing up. He or she has to go through a lot of difficulties and pain to mature. It's good to be optimistic instead. And I think the current state of the Korean film industry is probably in the same situation.
We all know that relationships in Hollywood don't last. It's very sad, but, you know, they're just very, very fickle. You have an extremely happy marriage. How do you make it work?
Just 4 months.
Four good months. Anyway, that's longer than most Hollywood relationships last.
Pretty much, it's important to make the best effort in any kind of situation. For instance, whatever the relationship is, be it love or work, if one is demanding and self-centered, the relationship won't last long. Again, what is important is whatever the relationship is, if one can make an effort to compromise and be understanding, it definitely helps.
So what does your husband think about all the attention that you get?
We are happy about it and enjoy it together. He takes pride in being part of my life.
Well, as we've been walking along, we've been collecting up a following of your fans. They've been all around here and waiting for you, obviously, to finish with this interview so that you can sign some autographs or something. So let me just ask you this in finishing. What's the next step for you professionally?
It's always been pretty much the same, I think, because that's the only way I can pay back, is to make good films. And that's what I always strive to do. That is my hope and dream.